Hello everybody and welcome to this tutorial. Today I will begin a chapter on SQL injections. Now before we actually begin the chapter itself and before I get into the injections themselves, before I do demos with this attack method and demonstrate in great detail how you can perform it, I do need to explain a few things first. So what is an SQL injection? In general, what do you think it is? Well, basically, as the name itself says, you're just injecting SQL queries into your HTTP request methods or somewhere else on the site. What you are doing with this, you are effectively pooling the database information that exists behind a web server, basically there's a website and that website pulls the information from a certain database in order to be displayed on that particular website. That is a way in which usernames and passwords are actually verified. You type it in, the web server takes it in, your website takes it in. Actually not the web server itself, rather instead the web app that you have on your web server takes in your user credentials. It compares them to the user credentials which are stored in the database. If they match, you are logged in, you get logged in. If not, you get denied, your access is denied. However, more often than not, user credentials, especially passwords, within the databases are encrypted. And that can be a problem, especially if they have MD5 hashes. It's not easy to break. There is a possibility always, but it can take a longer periods of time, and if somebody's using like a crazy long password or something of a kind, yeah, that's not gonna happen. And you might think now, oh well, why do we have to do this? Why should we do this at all? Because if we can't get the user credentials, then what does it matter? It does matter. It does matter to a great deal. First of all, you can get encrypted user credentials, and then you can use multiple computers to decrypt them in a shorter amount of time. That's one thing. That's one way. Or you can extract other useful information. And you might wonder, well, what other useful information is there? What can we use? Well, let me just remind you of a case that happened. Actually, this happens on a daily basis, but you don't really find it in the news or anything of a kind. A group of hackers, black hat hackers, they broke into a database, and even though the user credentials were encrypted, they were very well encrypted, and they had really good policies for passwords, so it really wasn't likely that they would ever get decrypted, that they would ever log in as those particular users. However, credit card information, credit card numbers, they were in plain text format and they could be read. So they took about 50,000 credit cards. Just imagine how many people were affected by this. 50,000 credit cards were stolen. I mean, what they did with them was probably that they sell them or they try to use some of them on the net or something of a kind to wash the money. But either way, I'm just trying to make a point here that user credentials are not the only useful type of information in a database. There's loads of stuff, and not just credit card credentials or something of a kind. There's loads of other stuff that you can find there that you can extract depending on what the site is. Sometimes you won't be able to get the password, but you will get a large amount of information in regard to a certain user. You will get pretty much whatever you want to get without actually authenticating at all. So whatever you wanted to do with after the authentication, so if you want to steal a password, for example, then log in as that user and then do something, take some information there, you will be able to take it this way without ever having to log in, which is fantastic, because still your connection of course gets logged by the server, and that can be problematic, but you can also issue commands to delete certain entries in the database, not just the SQL but others as well. And if there are some logs there, you can delete them. Sometimes you can even inject code, but that's not likely. However, you can actually inject SQL queries, and that is code in and of itself, so you can do a lot of stuff there. Anyway, without further ado, let's go ahead and set up a virtual lab, because we can't actually go about on doing this to random websites. As I said before, it's illegal and you can't do it. You shouldn't do it. I mean, physically you can, of course, technically you can, but you really shouldn't, primarily because it's legal. And I'm getting on somebody's nerves by repeating this. I am sorry for that, but it is necessary. I don't know, I feel a bit better by just saying that you shouldn't do it like that. There's no reason to do it illegally or anything of a kind when you can set up a perfectly functional pen testing lab on your own computer, on your own machine, where you can tune the difficulties, tune the defensive measures, etc., and then attempt to bypass them in peace without thinking that you're going to get caught or something of a kind. Anyway, one of the first things that we're going to need to download for this tutorial is a DAM vulnerable web application. So we need this, pardon for the expression, but that's the actual name of the web app. You need to go ahead and visit this website, so www.dvwa.co.uk. Go ahead and click on download. I think I've downloaded it like 5 times by now, because surprisingly somehow I've been managing to mess up my recordings. Save file, press OK. Go ahead and navigate over to your downloads folder, or you can just go ahead and directly open it from here. So one more time, click on the arrow in the upper right corner, click on the zipped file, you will see there's something here. Just click extract, and once you click extract here, files will be extracted to your default folder. Click quit. Your default folder for downloads is actually download. So go ahead and navigate over to your home folder. There we go. And go ahead and click on downloads. There we go. So it says DVWA. That's the file which we have extracted. I'm pretty sure that I've extracted it here. Yep, there we go. Anyway, so it's DVWA 1.0.8. I have extracted it several times and not sure where the files are going anymore, but it's going to be in the downloads folder. If you don't want to open it from here, from the browser, just go ahead and navigate over to your downloads folder, and there you go, you have a zipped file. I have 3 of them, 3 exactly the same files. Double click on it, click extract again, and click extract here, and that's it. No problems there. If my existing one just got overwritten, that's why I was a bit confused. I didn't have 2 of them. It says here overwrite existing files, recreate folders. But anyway, that's why I was confused. I thought I would have 2 of them, but apparently I have 1 because it was overwritten. Anyway, enough of that. So we have our folder here. It's downloaded, and now we need to copy it to our default web servers folder. You go ahead and open up your terminal, type in the following command, cp space dash capital R V. Capital R is for recursive mode, so it cp's all the subfolders as well, and V for verbosity, so that the cp command would tell you what exactly is it copying. Go ahead and type in slash home. Slash home, I need to, no, not home, sorry, root, oh, come on, why are you doing this to me, slash home, I am amazing, I am truly amazing, let's see where this is, type in a directory, it's in home test downloads. Okay, sorry. I am logged in as my regular user at the moment. I didn't realize that. So just type in cp space dash capital R V space slash home your username. My username is test. Yours can be, yours is probably something that you typed in, but mine is test. And type in, then type in downloads. And then you need to type in DV. There we go. So this folder is the one that you need to copy. And this folder you're going to copy into var www/. Press enter, and there we go. I have completed the copy. You can see the machine has actually told me every single file that it has copied. Clear us. Now, if you have been following through my other tutorials, you might have noticed, you might have some other files in this folder. Before I actually began this tutorial, I've cleaned this folder. It's slash, actually I'm gonna do it like this, pwd, print working directory. So if you have anything within this folder, you should really delete it prior to copying this. Or you can actually copy this and then delete everything else, but it's going to be easier before the copying itself happens. Just to make sure that there is nothing that will interfere in any way or manner with your web application. However, if you know what you're doing, you can have other things lying around here, no problems. Anyway, that would be it for this introductory video. I will continue immediately in the next tutorial from exactly where we left off now. However, until then, I bid you all farewell. And before I finish this tutorial, I would like to mention that I have been reviewing user requests, and there have been some people who have been asking for some additional tutorials on some very specific subjects. I will take them into consideration. I'll see if I can do them. If I can, time-wise, I will. However, please feel free to keep on posting your requests, demands, or whatever you wish. If you have a specific wish, okay, I want to have a tutorial on how to do this particular thing within the realm of ethical hacking, feel free to post it. I mean, I can't promise that I'll do it, but I'll definitely read it, and there is a chance that I will if I manage to get the time, or if I get enough requests or something of a kind. But I will read it, and I will consider it for sure. That much I guarantee it to you. Anyway, I bid you farewell, and I hope to see you in the next tutorial.